doing design, we need to be able to represent those design, and a very popular way of doing that is with diagrams. This course focuses on UML, using UML in constructing those diagrams, and the purpose of this lesson is to review for you some of the different kinds of diagrams that are there. There's lots of diagrams. We're not going to be using them all, but I'd like you at least to be familiar with what ones are there. So let's step back a little bit in history. Diagrams have been a popular part of software development from the beginning. I still have a flowchart template that you use for writing out the control logic of an algorithm. Over the years, various sophisticated diagramming techniques have developed. Okay, among those are SADT, Jackson design, structure design, and so on, each with their own particular approach to diagramming. In the 1980s, object-oriented techniques began to emerge, and with them, various techniques for diagramming object-oriented solutions. The first one we want to look at is called OMT.